Hello everyone, myself Mrs. A Doddi, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In today's lecture, we are going to study how to eliminate the errors in the bearing loads. At the end of this session, the students will able to find the errors in the included angles and the students will able to correct the bearing of the closed traverse. So what are the errors? The presence of any external magnetic influence such as iron, overhead cables, electric poles and the large quantities of the magnetic materials will affect the magnetic bearings. Normally, to measure the bearing of the survey line, we will use the prismatic compass. The prismatic compass will have the magnetic needle that will indicate the north and south direction. So due to that magnetic needle, so any the magnetic material present at the survey site, the bearing should reflect magnetic influence. So in that case, we will get the incorrect bearing. So that type of errors are called as the local attraction. So here we will see how to eliminate this local attraction. To eliminate these errors, we have to go with the included angle methods. So first, we have to calculate the included angles and we have to check whether the included angles are equal to 2n minus 4 into 90 degree. Okay. Then next, we have to find out the error and we have to correct the included angles. Then we have to find out the bearing line which will free from the local attraction. The bearing line which will free from the local attraction means the difference between the fore bearing and the back bearing of the survey line should be equal to 180 degree. If we are not getting the difference of 180 degree of the any bearing line, so in that case first we have to adjust the fore bearing and back bearing and we have to calculate the corrected bearing of the given traverse system. So this is the problem. If the bearing of line AB is 87 degree 25 north, 87 degree 25 minutes to the east, and that of the line BC is 65 degree 35 minutes 20 seconds east, then the deflection angle between the line A line at B is, means here we have to calculate the included angle B. Okay, so in this problem here we have to calculate the included angle B. So they are given the two survey lines, that is AB and the survey line BC, and we have to calculate the included angle B. Take some time and calculate the included angle B. Now in this problem, now we will see how to calculate the corrected bearings. The bearing of the lines of a closed traverse are given below. Determine the stations affected by the local attraction and the corrected bearings. So first of all, we have to draw the traverse with respect to this bearings. Now first we will draw the traverse. The forebearing of line PQ is 70 degree 40 minutes. So the forebearing of line PQ is 73 degree 40 minutes. Then the forebearing of line QR, it is 113 degree 50 minutes. So it is line second quadrant. Then forebearing of line RS, it is 164 degree. Again it is less than 180. So again it will line second quadrant. So the forebearing of line RS is 164 degree 20 minutes. Then the forebearing of line ST is 23 degree 40 minutes. So it is greater than 180. So it will lie in a third quadrant. So here this will be the forebearing of line ST. Then the last one is the forebearing of line TP. It is 303 degree 50 minutes. It is greater than 270. So it will be in fourth quadrant. So if we join the end points of the station P and station T, all we will get this forebearing of line TP which will lie in a fourth quadrant. So likewise, first of all we have to draw the closed traverse. Afterwards we have to find out the included angles of each bearing line. Now first we will draw the closed traverse, that is four bearing of line PQ is given as 73 degrees, 40 minutes, so it is station Q. Then four bearing of line QR is given as 113 degrees, 50 minutes, so it is station R. Then four bearing of line RS is given as 164 degrees, 20 minutes, it is station S. And the four bearing of line ST is given as 223 degrees, 40 minutes, and if we join these two end points, it will be the four bearing of station line TP, so which is given as 303 degrees, 50 minutes. Now we have to calculate the included angles. So here the included angle P, included angle Q, included angle R, here this one angle S, and here it is angle T. We will calculate the included angles. So here to calculate included angle P, we know the back bearing of line TP. The back bearing of line TP is this one. It is 123.45 degrees. So it is back bearing. Back bearing of line PQ is 252 degrees, 30 minutes. Back bearing of line QR is 295 degrees, 20 minutes. Then back bearing of line RS is given as 344 degrees, 20 minutes. Back bearing of line ST is given as 43 degrees, and the back bearing of line TP is given as 123 degrees, 45 minutes. Now we will calculate the included angle P. So included angle P means this internal angle. So if I can take the difference of the back bearing of line TP, that is back bearing of line TP minus the four bearing of line PQ, this one. Okay, so if I subtract the back four bearing from the back bearing of line TP, I will get the internal angle P. So here the back bearing of line TP is 123 degrees, 45 minutes, minus the four bearing of line PQ is 73 degrees, 40 minutes. So here we will get the included angle 50 degrees, 5 minutes. Similarly for angle Q, if you observe here the four bearing of line QR and the back bearing of line PQ are measured from the north direction only. So if I take the difference of these two, I can able to calculate the included angle Q. So here included angle Q is equal to back bearing of line PQ minus the four bearing of line QR, we will get the included angle. So here back bearing of line PQ is 252 degrees, 30 minutes, minus four bearing of line QR is 113 degrees, 50 minutes. So you will get the included angle Q as 138 degrees, 40 minutes. Similarly, we have to calculate for the included angle R. So it is back bearing of line QR minus four bearing of line RS, you will get the included angle R as 131 degrees. Then angle S, so it is back bearing of line RS minus the four bearing of line ST, you will get the included angle, that is 179 degrees, 20 minutes. But here if you observe the included angle T, T. Okay, so we will write here. So to calculate included angle T, first of all we have to calculate this external angle. We have to calculate first of all this external angle. So how we will calculate this external angle? So this external angle, here I will write. T, that is back four bearing of line TP minus back bearing of line ST. So four bearing of line TP is 303 degree 15 minutes minus back bearing of line ST is 43 degree. So here you will get 303 degree 15 minutes minus 43 degree as 260 degree 50 minutes. So this will be the external angle. So to calculate the internal angle T, included angle, so here we have to make, that is 360 degree minus exterior angle, that is 260 degree 50 minutes. So we will get this internal angle. Okay, and it will be 99 degree 10 minutes. So this internal angle is 99 degree 10 minutes, angle T. Okay, likewise we have to calculate the included angles of each station. Then we have to check whether the sum of all included angles should be equal to 2n minus 4 into 90 degree. Okay, so here we are having 5 stations, so the sum of included angles should be 540 degree. But when we calculate all these included angles, it is 598.15 degree. So it is greater than 540 degree. So now we are having the error of 58 degree 15 minutes, the total error. So that error should be divided in the 5 angles. So we will get the error of 11 degree 39 minutes for each angle. So that we have to subtract from the calculated included angle. So we will get the corrected included angles as shown in this table, that this should be equal to 540 degree. So after correcting the included angles, we have to check for which survey line we are getting the difference of fore bearing and back bearing as 180 degree. So here the difference of fore bearing and back bearing of line survey line RS gives the difference of 180 degree. So it indicates that the station R and S are free from the local attraction. So these readings are corrected readings. Okay, so here we will take as it is because the difference is 180 degree, and the fore bearing of line ST should be correct. Okay, because the station S is free from the local attraction. Now we have to calculate the back bearing of line ST. So this fore bearing of line ST is greater than 180 degree. So we have to subtract the 180 degree from the fore bearing of line ST. So we will get corrected bearing of line ST as 43 degree 40 minutes. Now we have to calculate the fore bearing of line TP. So here, as the change in the included angles, we have to consider the corrected included angles and we have to calculate the fore bearing of line ST. So here, so to calculate this fore bearing of line ST, we have to subtract this included angle, that is 87 degree 31 minutes, from the 360 degree, that we will get the exterior angle, and we have to add the back bearing of this survey line ST, so we will get the fore bearing of line TP. And to calculate the back bearing, here we have to subtract the 180 degree from this corrected fore bearing of line TP. So we will get the back bearing is 136 degree 9 minutes. Similarly, here we have to calculate the fore bearing of line PQ by considering the corrected included angles. Likewise, we have to calculate the fore bearing and back bearing by correcting the included angles. So these are the references considered for the study. Thank you.